third session in our module today is on building the problem statement. In fact, the right problem statement will help navigate the entire startup journey very, very effectively. Let us now look at our example of Netflix again. Going to the video store has been a pain, and people don't like traveling back and forth just to rent a movie and hate paying late fees. And version 2, going to the video store requires fighting traffic, wandering through aisles, and waiting in long queues just to get a single movie. Both these statements have the same intent, but the second one details out the pain and brings out an excellent narrative, which is very, very critical for defining a problem statement. Now, let us hear from Dr. Rupesh what he has to say about the problem statements developed by our IIT Hyderabad students in their startup projects. So, like, again, good afternoon, all of you. Let us now, today is a session where you are going to, present your problem statement. Yesterday, you formed your teams. We welcome Dr. Rupesh and we will see your problem statements, and we will just support you with mentors depending upon what your problem statement is, because it's the first time you're presenting. We will, leave it to you to, take this forward. Please go ahead, Vijay.
So this is team one. So we are consisted of five people: Gautam, Mayuri, Nikita, Shubhi, and me. So we came up with the idea that So how we can help visually impaired person to be a more self-reliant, in their daily activities, like cooking, shopping, traveling, banking, monitoring, transactions, dating, physical activities. So we are targeting on shopping. While shopping, there are some experience, high dependency on strangers, like shopkeepers, retailers, or lack of information while purchasing goods, or lack of choice and confidence by choosing the products, or lack of trust while handling over the money. So how we might reduce dependency of the visual impaired while they make a transaction for purchase goods. So here are the five W's, the visually impaired people affected with the blindness. We are targeting making transaction easier, and a proof of transaction. They face problems in the malls or grocery shops. Also in a banking transaction also, they have to depend on someone, strangers. And this is the objective. They are planning to come up with a product for the visually impaired that is customized for a printing bill, essentially on the receipts for the purchase they do in our shopping malls, to reduce their dependency on others for basic informations.
Very good. So that's quite okay. So we'll go, Rupesh, any comments on that?
It is good start, but since I'm aware of the field, so maybe slightly prejudiced, there is one IIT Bombay startup, IIT Delhi people who have worked, there are other people. What they do is they have their mobile connected to, there is a device which is there, which is called digital braille. So there is a startup of IIT Bombay, Mr. Sham is a IIT student, Sham, who worked on it. So you would be surprised at the rate at which visually impaired people can read braille. Okay, it is fantastic, and the speed is phenomenal. So they made a device which had a digital braille. Basically, there are six rods which come up. You feel that, and that is how people can understand what is the language. And these six letters, as in six, which one dot is up, which dot is down, based on that, the letter comes up. So he made a visual, he made a physical device which can convert this into whatever is connected to it, whether it is mobile, whether it is whatever. So the moment you dwell more into the problem, you'll understand the problem.
Good afternoon, everyone. Hi, my name is Mahima, and I'm here with Lakish here, Ved Valioka, Nirja Sonar. We are team four. And let us walk you through what our idea is. If you see, nowadays, we really can't live without phones. Everyone needs phones. We start our day with mobile phones or laptops, and we end with them too. Even during break times, our main focus is, let's just take a break. Okay, we'll just strip the tabs and we'll start playing games. Our lives are so dependent on these devices. But do you remember when we were kids, parents would go out, and every kid would be so happy that, oh, finally, lights are out. Let's go out and play. All the corn kids would get together And they would play various games like Kho-Kho, Luka-Chupi, they would play with those marbles. And these are our nostalgic summer theme memories. If we do not bring them back, what will happen to them? They'll be lost forever. Most of these games, they help you with hand-eye coordination, with your concentration, and mainly they help you with physical activity. Our problem statement is that, evolved from apes, we are trapped in apps. Everyone is so bound in technology that looking beyond is growing impossible. Our whole idea is to work around bachpan and bring these things back.
Yeah, looks good. We will see how you can narrow down further. No, Rupesh, we'll just check up how things can happen. So the problem should be much, much more clear. The context will be very clear. You clearly don't want to use technology in this, or is the technology enabled bachpan? We really don't know. So just get that clarity a little bit there. And then we are okay with, and then Indian aesthetics is too broad. So you be very focused with, I like your hand-eye coordination. Focus only on that, maybe. That can be a great selling point. So you need all these things in entrepreneurship. So maybe more will come when you take things forward.
Let there be a problem that has to be solved. So there is a reason why it's called a problem, right? As in, it's a good to have versus a problem. Windows are supposed to be there for keeping something open, so wind can come in, light can come in. There is a reason for it. So maybe define the problem which you are going to solve. That if you can come down to slightly proper, like Professor Chakravarti said, hand-eye coordination, then your persona will get developed for whom you're developing. Maybe it's a good idea to understand if the kids who are playing outside, there are certain advantages which are reported in some studies are missing in the current generation, in the current. So if more people are wearing, let's say, spectacles because they're hooked on the mobile or the concentration is low, if there is an evidence base, then that will help you to say that is a problem which you're going to address. That's a good start.
Yeah. So we go to team two, Anshul.
And we are a team of four people, Anshul, Pooja, Tito, and Vibhuti. So this is what our problem statement is. A stress among people in colleges and office due to long working hours. So we were targeting on mental health of people. So we were thinking of, is there something that can be done to these people in the time of short breaks which we take? Like everyone has... Our brain is programmed to just focus for 1 hour. And then it is important to take a 15 minutes break so that we again refocus and that keeps the efficiency of every person. So can we, what could be done in those 15 minutes which can be better for a person to be more efficient? What our thought was, like 5 minutes break, which we have sometimes in class also, if there is a 5 minutes of nap, like it's like a power nap, it feels much fresher than a half an hour or 1 hour of sleep. This is what our idea was. So in what way could we do that? So previously, basically, we already, in previous project, we had done a project on this with virtual reality. And we were thinking that was just an experiment, which is like a POC of concept that we tried at that time. And what we wanted is now we want to develop that as a product or some kind of a evolution to a second level, which can be implemented in something.
But once you go ahead in the course, you'll also understand customer discovery. Whom are you making for? When you talked about college students, when you go deep dive there, what would they like and how will you monetize it? So all that will come for sure into the things. But you can also define it further. Like basically during short breaks, so rather than long thing. And then how would you know that they are stressed?
If you are aware of Elon Musk, and if you are aware of the brain devices that he's working on, one of their elements work on a device which gives you kind of an energy. There is a device, TUFS related technology, through which you can try to reduce stress. So there has been effort in that direction, which has proven to reduce stress.
So, but make the statement a little bit more, from the all the aspects should come in more into the statement. Yeah, the statement should give us everything about your problem.
So our problem is what we collectively realized is that guided meditation is boring. And even though it's really boring, we still need it. The problem statement thus came down to finding alternatives and aids to developing mindfulness. Mindfulness is a concept that talks about living from moment, like experiencing moment from moment to moment, and not fixating on things that are in the past or in the present. And we were wondering if there could be a way where this act of focusing on your body, on your breath, on different points of the body, through yoga and guided meditation, it usually falls, like the burden of attaining enlightenment falls on the person and his ability to concentrate. So we were just thinking, what would be a better way to assist this path to enlightenment or feeling more mindful? And we decided to look for product design solutions, wherein there could be something as simple as a bug or a piece of marble that when you lie down, it travels across your body and it guides you where you should be focusing upon. Yeah, and we're just exploring how we can get into the market, which is already quite saturated with a lot of apps and products that encourage guided meditation.
Very good. I personally like this topic a lot. So I'll be, you know, I'll look forward for a solution. This is a fabulous area. And but you could be very, you know, I think your problem statement is too wide. Narrow down to just meditation, narrow down to just support during meditation, which will be more intuitive, which will be more, you know, inherent. So things like that, maybe much more definition in your problem statement. And, you know, you all know the advantages of meditation is phenomenal. You can just go there because that was exactly the problem you faced. And we'll check how many other people are facing that problem and what type of health benefits they get. So that's anyway there, knowledge is there. So like, and product design solution will be fabulous actually, because, you know, we really don't know whether it's possible to build such a solution, but with your creative thinking, you can surely build such solutions. Yeah. Rupesh, what do you say? This looks like a very, very interesting area.
Yeah. So again, interesting. Pinpoint problem and come down to that part. Where is the value that you'll be adding? Differentiate from good to have something which is just an accessory or an ancillary product to something which is a need-based thing. Maybe that is something. There are a lot of people who want to do this, but they do not know whether they are progressing. So monitoring is also something which helps you identify, if you quantify something. So that is something which if you try, you'll be able to come out from.
Like one of the aspects of mindfulness is also focused breathing. Mm-hmm. And we also realized that while practicing mindfulness can be a way to better react and respond to symptoms of asthma and COPD. And if that kind of mindfulness can be developed in patients with this disease, it would be helpful. So those are the kind of utilities we're also looking for, and maybe it can be more pinpointed in that direction.
Yeah, it's a good area. So define your unmet clinical need, if it's going to be towards any treatment, alleviation, or supporting any therapy. If that is what you are, then you are in medical device zone. Say there is a difference between Fitbit versus a temperature, which is a thermometer, which is medical grade. ECG versus Apple Watch, because Apple Watch never claims that it is for clinical use or medical use. It is something which you can measure, you can know, but there is no clinical relevance to it. So try to figure out whether you're going to be in the first zone or the second zone, because then the regulatory compliances are difficult. So choose the product accordingly. Both are valid, both segments are good.
Actually, we were mostly thinking to start it up as a brand and sell it as a brand instead of a product. So a brand that sells products which are designed to, so that people can pursue mindfulness.
Always come back to the part of value. Finally, Amazon could be a brand, but there is a service which either it is a product or service. Either it has to be one of that. That's it.
And I'm very happy that you're already talking about product planning, where you have six products and you choose the product you want. Fabulous. That's of course good, but that comes, you know, a little, you know, like further in the street where you have defined your, you know, statement very well. Your, you know, your brand, you know, the brand statement of what is your brand standing for. So, you know, and then maybe you're not in the clinical space. So think about that. If you're in the clinical space, the situation will be very different. Yeah.
Hi, this is Amir. We are Group 7. Our team members are me, Gaurav, and Karan. All are sitting here. We want to focus on the segment of backpacks, because backpack is something that everyone carries, and sometimes in the form of a bag, sometimes in the form of a trolley. So we have not narrowed it down to one problem statement, but we are focusing on one segment. And what we did was we brainstormed on the problems related to the backpacks, trolleys, and this particular segment. We jotted down every kind of and any kind of problem that we face. The first one was gamification of bags for school kids, trying to make the backpacks interactive for the children. Second one was a backpack for blinds. They cannot see, so make it something tactile and something in nature that a blind person can feel and interact with the backpack.
All the areas are perfect. So we'll, backpack with sitting or standing support, like I was talking about the chairware project. Fabulous, again, gamification of bags for school kids. Don't know weight of the luggage before going to airport. Wow, fabulous. A very important problem. Problem in taking out stuff from bag when it's on the back. Wow, we did this for the postman, where we had a both sling and a back support. Portable or convertible backpack for immigration labor workers. Wow. All of them, too good, very nice. Let us have much more detail and we'll know by tomorrow. Yeah, very good.
Yeah, sure.
Akanksha, next group.
So we zeroed down our focus area on traditional learning and classroom learning, which I think all of us have questioned after COVID with the online system setting in. So our problem statement that we have zeroed out right now is to remedial measures to transform the traditional classroom education system into a new and more flexible version, which is robust, agile, spatial, and tech-enabled. So we're still thinking on how we are going to put this forward, though we do have a project that we've been working on since earlier on education.
You let him be more specific, maybe? No? Within the education, what exactly are you seeing? What is the remedial measures you're seeing? Remedial measures are the people who are not passing out in classes. No, people who are not able to, but they don't learn something and they go to the next class because of they've not learned something, they can't go forward. No, that's the remedial classes they have so that they can cope up with the education. So just check out those things, and I think it's surely a good problem to solve. But from a business angle, from a what would you pinpoint on for making it very effective? Because a lot of these online platforms are coming in. How do you measure? How do you take things forward? It could be a very good thing for all these people. No, very very good topic and very pertinent for our condition.
I am going to present for the next group. So this is the team, and we started discussing and brainstorming. And after our discussion, we just came across with common points that we all felt like working towards. And the problem statement that we all agreed to work on was how might we bridge the gaps in the different social interactions. So there are different types of social interactions, and interactions are very important because they are not only a part of our social life, but they affect us emotionally, mentally, in all of those ways. So we were thinking that what are the different gap areas, or how do social interactions affect us? So some questions that have been mind-boggling us are basically the experience of, say, an individual who has been at home for so long and now needs to go out in the world and needs to do reconnect with people. So interactions between them, or maybe just children or kids who have been at home and have not been going to school for years now, for 3-4 years of schooling, and then they suddenly have to be in that environment. So other important things were generational gap, like there isn't any game that you can play with your parents to just have an interaction or promoting your thoughts or listening to what they think. So we just categorizing the different social, different gaps in social interaction and trying to understand how we can bridge this. And the initial vague idea that we have right now are kind of some sorts of games or activities, or say even a template form of how enhancing or encouraging such conversations.
This is a fabulous area, Ananya, very nice, but we can actually add all those things, social interaction between the elders and kids or whatever that, and you can add in that other aspect also. So you can build the problem statement already and lock in over there, because whichever is the toughest of the problem is actually the social interaction between, the elders and the, youngsters, the parents and children or uncles and nieces, whichever way. And, you're talking about game. So it can be a game-based interaction. So a game-based, gap bridging social interaction between elders.
Do something that's an icebreaker.
So icebreaker will that will be a solution. That will be a separate thing. But your problem statement could be this, where you're, bridging the gap between, elders and, two age groups basically. with a game. So game is very, very fixed. You know, like the gap is fixed and the people are fixed. So you need to really fix that. And please, you know, lock that in. It's a really, really good area. And it could be, you know, varied, you know, aspect that you can come up with. So we'll have detailed presentations later on when we have all the mentors and all together. But today is just to, you know, get our problem statement right.